Jay, SA Films, Tales from the Graveyard Shift, Walk with JSA. So, a lot of people, lots and lots of people, hundreds upon thousands of people, saying, what the hell? Look at hell, the hell kind of experience do you have? The hell kind of experience does JSA have? See, I'm asking you to vote for me for mayor because I know I could do this shit, but see, JSA Films, see, my resume, it speaks for itself. See, when I was 18 years old, I started a business in Yonkers. I gave a business to this city. When I was 16 years old, we were renting out VFWs and bringing bands to Yonkers, bringing commerce to this city. When I was 20 years old, I got a job working up the block. My first job, servicing the people of this city. See, it doesn't just start at security, it just doesn't start at cleaning up after the residents of the city. See, the people of the city, they would come onto my elevator at the old 7th Main Street, and I would bring them downstairs to the children's room. I'd bring them upstairs back to the main room, up to the second floor to the reference area, the third floor for the computer room. See, JSA Films, Tales from the Graveyard Shift, my resume, it speaks for itself. Where did that voice come from? See, my resume, it speaks for itself. There's a voice coming from back there. Tales from the Graveyard Shift. So when I was 20 years old and I first started, I operated that elevator and I operated it with pride. I was working for the city. I was bringing some people to their destinations. See, then it continued. See, once that building closed, there's no real reason to bring me to that building. They could have wished me well on my future endeavors, and it would have been nothing more of it. Now, but see, what these people did was they created a position for me. There was no need for a part-time custodian at that library. Everybody knows that. But I had my part-time job. I was a part-time custodian. I basically made my own hours, if you will. First, I was working from 7 in the morning to 12. And I remember the day like it was yesterday. I said, there's 4 custodians in here in the morning and me. There's 2 custodians at night. Wouldn't it just make more sense if I came in and worked at from 5 to 8? And then my boss, she said, all right, is that something you'd want to do? And I said, yeah. Of course, I had ulterior motives, which we will not discuss here. And I started working 5 to 8, still learning to clean up after my people, my city of Yonkers, still like under the tender age. I'm 21, 22 years old. Then eventually an old custodian man who was a preacher, priest or something. He retired. He left. He moved back to Puerto Rico and started a church. Or Lawrence Street, one of the two. And I got his position. A position that I shouldn't have even had in the first place, because they didn't need me over there, but they brought me over there. Because they knew the potential. They saw the potential. See, my resume, it speaks for myself. Every major event in Yonkers from 2003 when I was full-time until 2014 or whenever it was. I was involved with every Friday night when they first opened, when they'd have that jazz bullshit at the fucking pier, and then like at 11 o'clock, 10 to 12 people would come strolling in to the community room, yes, the community room, and they would show some movie from like 1924 or some bullshit, and I'd be sitting in there with a fucking security guard and what's his name, the building engineer kid, Miguel or whatever his name was. And I did that every Friday for months. I'd be in there at 1 in the morning in a brand new $53 million library. Just me until 1:30 in the morning. The same boardroom on the fourth floor that I got my dick sucked in is the same boardroom I eventually got fired in. What? Every major event, Family Day, the first Family Day, and Riverfest combined, I worked. Every Family Day and Riverfest from then until 2014, I worked. The first Yo-Fi Fest, I worked. Every stupid, dumb governor appearance, I worked. They tried to keep me home, but that didn't work. See, my resume, it speaks for itself. And like 2 or 3 or 4 years ago, I said and I proclaimed that they were robbing you people, robbing you, the city, the taxpayer cities of Yonkers. I had no idea at the time that I'd be running for mayor years later. See, my resume speaks for itself. So you don't keep a job like that for such a long period of time, being a bad worker. They knew. Some of them knew. Some of them saw the lights. See, my resume, it speaks for itself. 7 Main Streets to 1 Larkin Plaza to 15 Central, 100 Plentel Avenue to Main Street right now and to City Hall in the future. JSA Films for Mayor. JSA Films for Life.